copyrighted program created by Rio Grande.
Los Angeles Police calling all cars. Attention all cars. Broadcast 190. Regarding a person washed overboard from a Catalina boat. Described as male, American, about 30 years old, wore a straw hat, a gray suit. Reported lost near the west end of the island. That's all. Rosenquist.
California's best cooks chose a certain brand of canned foods, and all canned foods were the same price, you'd be pretty sure to stick to that brand now, wouldn't you? If California's best interior decorators recommended a certain brand of rug, and all rug prices were the same, I'm sure you'd like to know that brand when you are ready to buy rugs. There are outstanding authorities in every field, and when you buy contrary to the judgment of those who are qualified to know best, you lose in money and efficiency. The biggest buyers, the biggest users, the greatest testers of gasoline in California are your city and county governments and the men who drive your police cars, fire engines, ambulances, and emergency equipment. They have predominantly chosen Rio Grande Crack as the finest gasoline obtainable. 30 of your cities and counties have specified Rio Grande Crack gasoline in competition with all other brands. Thousands of intelligent motorists who think about their purchase of gasoline have changed to Rio Grande Crack. For 2 years, Rio Grande led all other brands of gasoline in percentage of sales increase. Last month, more motorists got police car performance from their cars with Rio Grande Crack gasoline than in any June in Rio Grande history. Don't put off the money-saving, satisfaction-gaining change. You will agree with the best authorities that only Rio Grande Crack will give you police car performance in your car. Think when you buy gasoline. And now we present Mr. Buron Fitz, the District Attorney of Los Angeles County. Mr. Fitz.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I have just left a meeting where we are interviewing new and important witnesses in the Inglewood murder case. A meeting to which I must return. But I could not miss the opportunity to cooperate with Calling All Cars, which is doing so much in the public interest with its crime prevention and law enforcement work. Many times criminal impulses are aroused by the reading of a crime committed by a hardened criminal who apparently got away with it. A prospective criminal does not realize that he has not heard all of the story. That the man who seemed to get by with his crime is in the end apprehended and punished. Tonight's story deals with a group of people who had no criminal record. They saw that they thought was a good opportunity to commit a crime similar to those they'd heard of. They thought they saw the opportunity to collect some easy money. That this crime did not pay, you will see from this program. But I'll tell you more about it at the end of the show.
Two and a half hours out from Avalon, the Catalina Flyer was nearing a stretch of rough water off the west coast of Catalina Island. The hot July sun beat down on the upper deck. Below, the passengers were enjoying the cooling breezes of the Pacific. Suddenly, from the deck above, came the voice of the captain.
Man overboard! Man overboard! Close to stern! Out of port! Who is it?
Oh, it's my husband. He went off on deck after my first.
There, look. I see him. There he is.
Where? Oh, John!
I'm going to try to help him.
Shark up in there, man. You'd never save him in this water.
Are you going to stand there and let my husband drown?
There's nothing we can do, ma'am, that we're not doing. I've got every hand on board keeping a sharp lookout for him.
But this man says he saw him.
That was the seal, ma'am. No one has seen your husband since he went overboard.
Take up a chair, Captain.
All right. Just keep circling and see if you can get a trace of Mr. Dexter.
Oh, only I haven't sent him up after
now,
my first.
Now, don't blame yourself, Mrs. Dexter. You're not responsible.
He picked up this purse in the man's hat, sir.
Oh. Well, that's Mr. Dexter's hat, all right.
Is this your purse, Mrs. Dexter?
Oh, yes. Oh, my poor John. I never should have let him come on this trip. I knew something terrible would happen.
Now, Mrs. Dexter, don't take on so. It wouldn't be helpful, no?
It could. I could have kept John on shore. I had a feeling something would happen.
Well, I guess there's nothing else we can do now. We might as well go on back to Avalon.
Don't worry about Mrs. Dexter, Captain. We'll take care of her.
Thanks, Mr. King. I'll be with you as soon as I make my report on the accident.
We'll take the first boat over to the mainland. See if Mrs. Dexter gets home all right.
I want to thank you for all you've done for me, Captain McAfee. I'm sorry if I seem to blame anyone for this, but John and I
understand all right, Mrs. Dexter. And I'm awfully sorry about it, too. Well, I'll be rowing back to the boat. I'll see you later, Mr. King.
California versus John Dexter Bell, Dexter and W.N. Henry, defendants.
Well, the counsel stipulates that the jury's in the box.
Both stipulated.
Call your first witness for the people, Mr. Clark.
Captain McAfee.
Captain McAfee. Raise your right hand. You solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give in this case to be the truth, all truth, nothing but the truth, self you God.
I do.
Take a stand.
What is your name?
Joseph McAfee.
Captain McAfee of the Catalina Fire?
Yes, sir.
Captain McAfee, do you know the defendants? Dexter, John, and his wife, Belle.
Yes.
You know the defendant, W.N. Henry?
Yes, sir.
Tell the court in your own words where and when you first met the defendant, W.N. Henry.
Well, one morning, I think it was the 13th of July, I was walking along Christmas Street. Good morning. I'm Captain McAfee. I understand you're looking for me.
Oh, yes, yes. My name is W.N. Henry. I've got a proposition I'd like to talk over with you.
All right. What is it?
Well, something I can't discuss here. And we go somewhere and talk this over?
Well, that all depends on what it is.
Hmm. Are you interested in making some easy money?
We're all interested in that.
Anybody but a sucker is.
Tell me, is this rum running? If it is, I'm not interested.
No. It's nothing like that. This is a safe proposition. You don't run any risks at all. We'll pay you well for your work.
Yeah, I've been having a little trouble lately. Keeping my boat running. Naturally, I'm out to make all the money I can, honestly. But I'm not out to get any dishonesty.
Well, you don't have to worry about this.
Well, who are you connected with?
I'd rather not say. But I can tell you that it's an insurance company.
Oh. Well, how do you plan to make any money from me?
Well, we need a boat that we can shove a guy over.
You sure you're not connected with anyone over here on the island?
No, of course not. Why?
Well, there's a group over here that's been trying to frame me. They wouldn't stop at anything.
I'll tell you what. Let's go over to the mainland where we can work this thing out in private. I'll give you all the proof you want that I'm on the level with you.
All right. I'll see you tomorrow night. And the next day, I went over to Los Angeles and got a room in a hotel.
Are you in the habit of coming to the mainland?
Yes, sir. I come over every week or two.
When did you see the defendant, Henry, next?
I saw him Monday night. That's the next night. He came down to the hotel, we had dinner, and then he told me all about this drowning scheme.
I tell you, McAfee, it's a sin. This guy Cameron will go for it, and you can make $2,000 just like that.
Well, I don't know. Looks fishy to me. What company did you say it was?
I didn't say.
Oh.
All you need to know is the time and the man. You point out the proper place for him to fall overboard and leave the rest to us.
Well, how do you know he won't really drown?
Well, it won't make any difference to you. He'll get your $2,000 just the same.
Yeah, but it's going to be pretty hard on him, though, isn't it?
No. This guy Cameron's a perfect setup for this thing. He's got only one leg. Everybody will know he can't swim. I tell you, McAfee, we can't lose.
When do you want to pull this off?
Well, I figure that Cameron... Ought to go around the island with you once before we do the job. Suppose we arrange to be over there next Saturday. You make the trip Sunday, look everything over, and we can make the final arrangements then.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm going to be in town until the middle of the week. Why don't you come down to the hotel Wednesday night and bring this fellow along and work out the details?
Yeah, that's a swell idea. I'll see you about 8 o'clock Wednesday night.
So I went on back to the hotel and kept thinking about this thing. I had some friends in an insurance company, one of the biggest ones. So I called them up and told them about this thing.
Then what happened?
Well, the company sent their attorney over to see me, and when they found out what the scheme was, they suggested calling your office. That is, the district attorney's office.
Did you do that?
Yes, sir. The company didn't know whether the policy was in their company, but they said that whoever wrote the policy should be protected. So their attorney called up the district attorney's office, and Mr. Ramsey over there and Mr. Reamer came down to see me. They got there just about 7:30.
When's this going to be pulled off?
They plan to make a rehearsal trip, he called it, around the island next Sunday and then do the job a week from them.
You know who this so-called victim is to be?
Well, he called the man Cameron, but he slipped up once and almost said something else. I don't believe that's the right name.
When's he coming back?
Yeah, they're both coming here this evening, about 30 minutes.
You reserved this room next door for us?
Yes, sir. Room 507. This door right here connects with it. Yeah, you can see there's a big crack under the door. You'll be able to hear everything that's said.
Well, look here. We'll go downstairs and register for the room. You go down to the lobby, and as soon as these birds come in, we'll follow you upstairs.
Okay. And I'll just act as if nothing had happened. Then I went downstairs like the officer said, and in a few minutes, Mr. Henry there came in.
Was he alone?
No, sir. That other man there, Mr. Dexter, was with him.
Did he introduce the man as Dexter?
No, sir. He called him Cameron.
When did you learn that his real name was Dexter?
When we got to the room.
Did you see the officers, Ramsey and Reamer, enter the room next to yours?
No, sir, but I heard them go in just as we closed the door to my room.
What was said then by either of the defendants?
Well, Mr. Henry went into the room first. Hey, just sit over there, Mr. Henry. You'll find that chair by the door comfortable.
Thank you.
You can sit here, Mr. Cameron.
Oh, yeah, McAfee. As long as we're going to work this deal together, you might as well know Cameron's real name. It's Dexter. John Dexter.
Oh. Well, why the secrecy? Don't you fellas trust me?
Well, frankly, McAfee, if Dexter hadn't seen fit to go through with this, I would have had to get somebody else.
I see. Well, what's the plan?
Well, we plan for Dexter here to go over to the island.
Will you speak a little louder, please, Mr. Henry? I seem to be a little dull tonight in my hearing.
Oh. You better see the doctor about that. Well, as I said, we're planning on sending Dexter and his wife over to the island next weekend. And we'll make the trip around the island with you to look things over.
About how long does it take, Captain?
Well, about 4 or 5 hours, depending on the weather.
Does it get rough?
Yeah, it usually does along around the west end of the island.
West end? And that would be the best place to pull the job.
Well, let's get this straight. Does he really go overboard?
Oh, no. You get around to that rough water, you'll warn everybody to go below to be safe. And we'll find some excuse for him to stay on deck. You fix it so he can go below from the forward end of the boat. He can hide there until you get back.
Yeah, there's a hatch that leads down to cabins we don't use anymore.
Well, that's the very place for him to hide.
Well, when does he get ashore?
After you dock the boat, you take it out to Anchorage, don't you?
Yes.
You can roam ashore then.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't see the profit in all this.
Very simple. You see, we've got him insured for $10,000, double indemnity.
Oh.
Dexter gets part of it, you get $2,000, and I get the rest.
Mm-hmm. Well, who pays all the premiums on this policy? It must cost a lot.
Not at all. You see, I'm the adjuster for the company. I take care of all that. We just put in notes for the premiums, and the company never gets wise.
You must be pretty smart to think up a gig like that.
Oh, I didn't think it all up by myself. We used to work it all the time back in Kansas City. Say, you remember the Diploma Mill case they had back there?
Yeah, I read about it.
Well, that's where we really got the idea. We get those guys that have got their doctor's diploma from one of those places, then we go to work.
Oh, is that the way you got Mr. Dexter passed? Physically, I mean?
Sure. We've got angles we work on these things.
Yeah, but tell me, what about this man's wife? What's she going to say about this?
Oh, her? Oh, she'll be in on it. She'll act like she really thinks he's drowned.
Well, what are you going to do if you get caught?
Oh, caught? Not a chance in the world of getting caught. It's a lead pipe cinch, I tell you. Why, the DA and the sheriff's crew will never get wind of this thing in a million years.
And while this conversation was in progress in room 508, your room, Who else was present?
Just Mr. Henry, Mr. Dexter, and myself.
Just a minute, Mr. Clark. At no time was Mrs. Dexter present in the room?
No, sir.
And where were the officers, Ramsey and Raymer, at that time?
Why,
You think, you know. I want what you know.
I'm not sure. I heard them go into the room, the room next door.
Could they have heard this conversation?
Objected to on the grounds of his hearsay testimony and calls for a conclusion of the witness.
The same.
Do you know whether or not the officers heard this conversation?
No, sir, I do not.
Was the conversation sufficiently loud for them to hear it?
Objected to, same reason.
The same.
Did you make any arrangements to meet Dexter and Mrs. Dexter at any later date?
Yes, sir. They were to come over the following weekend.
Good morning, Mr. Dexter.
Fine day for your trip.
Yes, it is. Oh, Bell, this is Captain McAfee, my wife.
How do you do?
Pleased to meet you, ma'am. I've talked this thing over with my wife, and she seems to think it's too risky.
Well, you know best about that, but...
I'm afraid something will go wrong. I wouldn't want anything to happen to John.
Well, don't worry about that part of it. We'll see that he's safe. Come up forward here. I'll show you the hatch.
All right.
There's a cabin directly beneath the pilot house. We've got some old mattresses and some pieces of sail stored there now, but we can find a place to hide, Mr. Dexter.
Boy, it's going to be hot in there in this weather.
I'll say. Here's the hat.
Oh, my, it's dark down there.
The better to hide me, my dear.
Now, you can just get down the ladder and look around if you want.
I wouldn't have consented to this at all, but we need the money so badly. I've got to go to the hospital next week for an operation.
Do you know this Henry fellow very well?
No. I just met him last week when he came out to talk to John. I didn't want John to take out the policy with Mr. Henry, but he's so easily influenced. As soon as he'd get away from me, he'd let them talk him into anything.
Yeah, some men are that way.
Everything clear?
Yeah. You can come on up.
Boy, oh boy. Glad to get out of that hole. Hot down there.
Well, what did you expect in the middle of July?
I didn't know it'd be this hot. Which way do we sail out of here on this map here?
Why, you see, we go up north here to Cabrillo Harbor.
Mm-hmm.
Past Empire Landing, in between Bird Rock and Ship Rock, into Isthmus Cove, and then around Land's End.
Do we stop at Ironbound Bay?
No, we don't stop at all. We just keep close to the shore along here, past Indian Head, China Point, on down to Silver Canyon. Somewhere between Silver Canyon and Seal Rocks here is the rough water. The best point for our stunt.
You will be careful, won't you, John?
Sure. Don't worry about me.
Well, what do you plan to do after we get to shore?
Well, I'll go back to Wilmington on the boat that leaves just before 5:00.
And I'll go back for the first boat after we dock.
Henry has arranged to have a fellow meet me in a car. He's making a trip to the valley, and I'm going as far as El Centro with him.
When's your wife going to join you?
Just as soon as she gets our money. She's going east to visit her mother.
And then John will meet me there, and we'll be remarried.
Oh. So you'll marry the widow of John Dexter?
Yep, that's the story.
Well, you know what'll happen to you if you get caught, don't you?
Sure. You'll get a stretch in San Quentin.
Yeah, at least that. Well, here comes some more passengers. You better grab a couple of chairs. I told them they'd better grab a couple of chairs and get comfortable. Pretty soon the other passengers came aboard and we cast off.
Who else was on board you recognize?
Mr. King and his wife.
Eddie King of the district attorney's office?
Yes, sir.
What was he doing on board?
Well, I'd been told by the district attorney's office to go through with the plan.
That was your only reason for going ahead with the fake drowning?
Yes, sir. To help the officers catch the others.
What did Mr. King do while on board your boat?
He watched Mr. Dexter. They all got acquainted with each other.
Did Mr. Dexter or his wife mention this affair to Mr. or Mrs. King?
Well, not that I know of.
Did anyone else on board your boat know of this scheme?
Well, no, not at that time. Later, I had to tell my engineer, but that was the next week.
Did anything out of the ordinary happen that day, the 21st of July?
No, sir.
You just made the routine trip.
Yes, sir. We just sailed around the island.
When you came to the rough water, what did you do?
I told the passengers to go below. We always did that.
Did they all go?
Yes, sir.
Then what happened?
Well, Mrs. Dexter said she'd forgotten her purse, and Mr. Dexter went up after it.
Was that according to plan?
Yes, sir.
Then what happened?
Well, we came back and docked, and the passengers all went ashore.
Did you leave Dexter on board that day?
No, sir. We all came ashore.
Now, Captain McAfee, I want you to tell the court and the jury in your own words just what took place during the following week and on Saturday and Sunday, July 26th and 27th.
Well, it has been arranged that Mr. and Mrs. Dexter would come over and...
Hello, Mrs. Dexter.
How are you today?
Fine. How's it going?
Fine. How are you, Mrs. Dexter?
Splendid, thanks. Have you seen Mr. and Mrs. King?
Oh, yes. Yes, they're up at the hotel. They've got rooms right next to yours.
Thanks a lot, Captain, for getting the rooms for us. We might have had to sleep on the beach.
Well, we'd have found a place for you. Maybe in the forward cabin, eh?
No, thanks. Those 2 hours tomorrow will be enough of that for me.
You still want to go through with it?
Sure. I need that jack.
Well, we better get over to the hotel. Well, we went over to the hotel, and Mr. and Mrs. Dexter went up to their room. I didn't see them anymore that day. Not until 11 o'clock Sunday morning. They came down to the pier with Mr. and Mrs. King and several other people from the hotel.
Right this way for the glass bottom boat. Get your tickets.
Good morning, Mr. Dexter. Fine day for your trip.
Beautiful day. Too beautiful to get drowned on.
Somebody get drowned?
Oh, no. John was just clowning.
I see. Well, there have been several people lost around here. Over on the other side of the island, though. Usually, carelessness on their part.
Well, we better get started. Mrs. Dexter, you go first. Mrs. King. Your next is King.
We all got on board and headed the boat up the coast.
Was Mr. Henry on board?
No, sir, he wasn't.
Did Dexter mention Mr. Henry?
Yes. Yes, he said that Mr. Henry would meet him when he got on shore at Wilmington.
What did you do on the trip around the island?
Why, after we'd been out from Avalon about 2.5 hours, I called to Mr. Dexter to one side. You're almost up to the place where you decide to pull your axe.
I don't know whether or not to go through with this thing. Here comes my wife.
John, isn't it about time? If you're going to do it?
I've been debating it for half an hour.
Well, if you think you shouldn't do
it. Oh, I don't know. What have I got to lose?
A whole lot. If you do go overboard, haven't we, Captain?
Well, you're the best judge of that, ma'am.
What kind of signal shall we use?
Let's see. Look, when I put my hand out like this and lean against the pilot house, you'll know the coast is clear.
When you send everybody below, when we get to the rough water, we'll stay close to the stairs and watch it.
Yeah, you better get ready. It's getting to get rough.
Yeah, we'll be watching you.
Everybody below decks, we're coming to rough water. Everybody. Won't be safe up here on the upper deck. Come on. Let's all go below. I'll call you soon through it.
Come on, dear. Let's get below. I want to get a seat near the portal.
All hands, stand by. Rough water.
Do you think?
Not yet.
John, I wish you wouldn't do this.
Why, darling?
Well, it isn't honest.
But, darling, you've got to get the money for your operation. You've just got to go through with it.
I wish you hadn't let Henry talk you into this. Honestly, I'm frightened.
Oh, now, there's nothing to be afraid of.
You'll be careful, won't you?
Sure. Oh, well, there's the captain's hand on the side of the pilot house.
John, I left my purse on deck. I'm afraid it'll fall overboard. Can you get it for me?
Sure thing. Be right back.
I'm so careless about those things. John's always having to pick up after me. Why, just last night
Mary
I...
Mary O'Lord! Mary O'Lord! Hold on, Peter Scratch! Hard aboard!
Well, we circled around for a while, pretending to look for Dexter. But I'd seen him go down into the forward hatch, and I knew he was safe.
Do you know what happened after you came into port?
After everybody left the boat, we took her out to anchorage, and later I rowed out and got Dexter out of the forward hold and had the engineer put him ashore.
Did you see him after that?
No, sir. Not until I saw him here today.
That's all, Captain McAfee. Call Eddie King.
Eddie King. Raise your right hand. Solemnly swear the testimony about to give in this case to be the truth, all truth, nothing but the truth, self you God.
I do.
Take the stand.
Your name is King?
Edward King. District Attorney's Office.
Were you on board the Catalina Flyer on the day of July 27th?
I was.
Did you see the defendant, John Dexter, leave the salon and go on deck after the boat had reached rough water?
I did.
What did you do then?
I leaned out of a window, and I saw him go on deck, throw a purse, 2 chairs, and a straw hat overboard.
Hmm. Then what did he do?
He opened the forward hatch and went below.
Did you see him again that day?
I did.
Where?
On the docks of the steamship company at Wilmington.
When was this?
Late in the afternoon of the 27th of July.
He was alone?
No.
He was with W.N. Henry and officers Albert Ramsey and Charles Reamer. He was under arrest for participating in a...
You, W.N. Henry?
Yeah. Yeah, who are you?
Investigator Ramsey, District Attorney's Office. This is Charlie Reamer, another officer.
DA's office, eh? So what?
So you're under arrest.
Arrest? For what?
For conspiring to defraud an insurance company.
Oh, yeah? Who says so?
I do. Your friend Dexter here has been under my watchful eye for a couple of weeks now.
Besides, we were in room 507 in that hotel where you met McAfee.
506. Oh, McAfee double-crossed me, did he?
Oh, no. No, he merely carried out the DA's orders. He's been working with us all the time. That's what we call crime prevention insurance.
Tomorrow, when you stop and think before buying gasoline, and then decide to follow the judgment of the most important buyers and users of gasoline, you'll go to your Rio Grande dealers for Rio Grande Crack. If you're not already using Sinclair Motor Oils, you'll discover a double incentive for patronizing your independent Rio Grande dealer. 52 railway systems fight friction and wear with Sinclair Oils. 150 airplanes, airplane manufacturers, and flying fields have tested, approved, and used Sinclair Oils. Fleets of ships and trucks and great industrial and manufacturing plants operate their equipment under the Sinclair Law of Lubrication with Sinclair Oils. 1 out of every 9.5 gallons of oil sold in this country is Sinclair. What does this mean to you? Well, out of many exclusive qualities of Sinclair Oils, this one is probably the most important to you right now. Sinclair Oils contain no petroleum jelly, while most of the oils you buy do. Petroleum jelly, under hot summer driving, melts like butter, and your engine can wear itself out. Sinclair Oils cannot break down under this summer's most intense heat and at the fastest speed you may drive. You save money by buying less oil, preventing repair bills, and lengthening the life of your car. Sinclair Opaline in tamper-proof cans costs but 25 cents per quart. Sinclairize for safety with Sinclair Motor Oils. Get police car performance with Rio Grande Crack Gasoline. Again, we present District Attorney Buron Fitz. Mr. Fitz.
Officers took Dexter and Henry to Dexter's home and arrested Mrs. Dexter. As a result of the trial, Henry was sentenced to San Quentin Penitentiary. The sentence later fixed at 4 years. Dexter was given a sentence of 1 year, and Mrs. Dexter a suspended sentence. Thus, another crime failed to pay.
Thank you, Mr. Fitz.
Police calling all cars, attention all cars. A cancellation broadcast 190 regarding a drowning. This case proves to be a fake accident. Suspect taken into custody. That's all. Rolls and clues.
Michael Parkhurst, bidding you good night for Rio Grande.